this Ivanti video, I'm going to show you how to take design updates from a test database into your live database using the Test to Live application that's provided with a Service Desk and Asset Manager. As your business changes or as your adoption of ITIL matures, your Service Desk or Asset Manager implementation needs to evolve to match your requirements. The typical method for managing these changes is to take a copy of your database, implement and test your changes in that copy, and then transfer the necessary changes to your live database using Test to Live. You could introduce a pre-production system between your test and live systems to give you more confidence in the migration, but that's a topic for another video. In this video, I'm going to demonstrate migrating directly from a test system to your live system. While you are implementing and testing your changes in the test system, you can carry on using your live system as before. Just don't make any design changes in your live system. Don't use any of the designers, including the dashboard and query designers, or add any shortcuts. Sometimes, for operational reasons, you will have to add new groups, service agreements, and list items, but things are a little easier if you can avoid this. The full list of items you must not change in Live are listed in the description below this video, along with a link to the help page for Test to Live. Right, let's get started. The first step is to back up your Live database and restore it to your test system. Test to Live migrates the differences between your two systems, so you need to start your test system based on an exact copy of your live system. I've created an instance called Test that is a duplicate of my live system. I'm guessing you don't want to watch me make all of the design changes, so I'll pause the recording now so that we can jump forward and just review the changes I'm going to make to my test system. Here are my test and live systems. On the incident process in Test, I've added a Create Test action on the open status. This included creating a new object, a collection, an action and a window. As you can see, this isn't in Live yet. Now, let's compare the support groups in my two systems. As you can see, in Test, I've added a group called Test and renamed the Asset Configuration group to Asset Config. In Live, I've added a group called Live. Test to Live will move my new test group to Live and will leave the new Live group in the Live system as it is. The modification to the asset configuration group in Test, however, will not be moved to Live. Modifications and deletions to groups, roles, lists, and service levels are not migrated by Test to Live. For changes made to connections created in the Data Connections or Desktop Manager components, or for changes made in the Mail component, you are given a choice of whether or not to migrate your changes. In the test system, I have changed the mailbox to use my test mail server. This is the kind of change that you wouldn't want to migrate to Live. However, if you changed a mapping, you would want to migrate that change. Note though, that you cannot pick and choose which changes to the mail setting you are going to migrate. You just get to choose whether or not to migrate all of the changes. Finally, I've noticed that my American English system has the dictionary language set to UK English in the system settings. You can use Test to Live to migrate system settings, so let's correct that setting in Test. Now that we've inspected the changes that I've made, let's migrate those changes to Live. As with any change to your database, we strongly recommend that you take a backup of the databases that you are working with. I recommend backing up both Live and Test before starting. Now stop the Service Desk application pool on all the servers for the live system to stop anyone making any other changes. I've backed up my databases, so now I'm going to start the Test to Live application. Run Test to Live from the LAN Desk group on the Start menu. Enter the credentials for the test database and the live database. In the live database group box, select the DB is backed up checkbox. Please make sure that you do back up your live database. If something does go wrong for any reason and you don't have a backup, all we'll be able to offer you is sympathy. Click Connect. Test to Live loads the databases and determines what changes it needs to migrate. Because we have made changes to the mail settings, we are asked what we want to happen with these changes. The changes I'd made were to connect to a test mail server to use while testing my new design, so I don't want to migrate these changes. So I click the Retain Difference option. We're ready to go. So we can click Start Sync. Test to Live syncs the test and live databases, which could take a while. and it's worked. Now we can restart the Service Desk application pool and take a look through our live system to see what's happened. As you can see, my optional action is now available in the incident process. I now have a test support group that I created in test and still have my live support group that I created in live. However, the change to the name of the asset configuration group that I made in test has not been migrated. You need to make a note of changes and deletions such as this while doing your development work so that you can make these changes in live afterwards. My mailbox is still using my live mail server. And finally, the dictionary language is now set to US English. When you are happy with your new live system, take another backup of it and use this to update all of your test and pre-production environments ready for the next round of updates. Thank you for watching this Ivanti video. I hope you found it useful. It's only intended to give you an introduction to Test Alive. Much more information is available in the product help and in documents on the Ivanti community. I've included links to both in the video description. And don't forget to subscribe to our channel to get more videos like this.